Hey everybody! Happy Thursday. I'm Rashida Lucas.
And I am Dalila Lucas.
And we are your favorite Lucas twins. What up though? How y'all feeling tonight? Please feel free to do comments. We will definitely be listening to comments today. So I guess we can do some current affairs before we get started.
We definitely can.
What do you want to talk about?
I want to talk about Deion Cole.
Oh, I love Deion Cole.
Love you, Deion Cole. I want to talk about the uproar that is going on about the suit that he wore that was bell bottoms.
Well, you want to know what's crazy? Yeah, like people have been, you know, saying homosexual stuff, like he's gay. And I like the post that he put up about how it's always us. It's always us that's on each other and, yeah, you know, calling people gay. First of all, I know Deion personally. I know for a fact the man is not anything close to homosexual whatsoever.
At all.
But what's crazy is, let's go back. Since it's Throwback Thursday, let's go back to Soul Train. In the 70s, all men wore bell bottoms. That was just a thing. Women and men wore bell bottoms. So because it's just crazy. Like, everything is gay. No, nothing is gay unless a person says, hey, I'm gay and I like the same sex.
Right, exactly.
So what do you have? Okay, we can't have too much silence. But I don't agree with what everybody's saying. But again, you know, that's what people do. It's the internet, it's social media life. Everybody wants to drag somebody for something. You were a party in your head, they're gonna drag you. It's just, it's ridiculous.
It's sad. It's super sad to me. And I'm tired of it.
Well, you know, that's what your people do. I only have 2 more days to be black.
Oh, so you can be black again. That's right.
No, I'm not going to be black again. I'm going to identify as an Arabic woman again, starting March 1st, which is Sunday.
Oh, you only black for Black History Month.
Only because, you know, I had to. The only reason I did it was because there are so many people who, you know, just, I'm not being funny now, just all jokes aside, there are too many leaders and civil rights leaders back in the day who did a lot for us today and our descendants and generations after that. They did too much for me to not acknowledge Black History Month. And I actually know some people. Speaking of Black History Month closing out, I want to give some love to Miss Brenda Thompson. Miss Brenda Thompson was the first black female ever
commissioner
to be a commissioner in the United States.
Yes.
And we happen to know her personally as well. Funny as shit.
Hilarious.
Hilarious. She can cook her ass off. And she has a beautiful spirit. I love Miss Brenda. I love her. I got to sit and talk to her for like hours. We were at the house by ourselves. If you all don't know, that's R&B singer, Grammy nominated Selena Johnson's mother. So I've been able to sit, you know, with Miss Brenda and talk to her and actually listen. Like, I love her. I see why she became a commissioner. Not only that, her daughter's following her footsteps, not as far as being a commissioner, but just being very, very goal oriented.
Yeah, being leaders, all for women. Yes, love it.
Yeah.
Love
it. So, so it's people like that and people I know personally. I had to reflect on Black History Month. But come Sunday, I'm done with you, Negroes. And the Deion Cole is another reason why. I'm done. I'm over it.
It's, yes. So, just want to say, hey, Nadine.
Nadine? That girl named Candace.
Just say Nadine.
Hey, Candace!
Is that her middle name?
Yes.
OMG. Hey, Candace.
You didn't know who that was all that time?
Well, I know it's Candace Nadine, but it's a lot of Ushers.
I know, but yeah.
Hey, Candace.
That's Nadine.
Hey, Key. Hey, Chikuti and Ray Ray, thank y'all for tuning in.
Man, so, right, I love y'all. Continuous
thank
support.
Thank you for the support, yes. Now, back to the Deion Cole
and thing. Nadine, we got to get you on here. You are like a serial entrepreneur.
Yes.
This girl is so talented. Many hats. And bras,
many hats.
I guess.
She got more hats than the store lids.
Right. This lady does everything. I just saw something else recently on, like, Ella told, like, girl, you do everything. This girl can draw. She creates Christmas wreath with balls,
balloons, she does
makeup, hair,
jewelry, she's a teacher.
Right, and she's a vendor at all of the Caribbean Fest during the summertime.
Yeah.
Where she has her own vending booth with these drinks that are like
so good.
And cool and
so good.
You doing your thing, cuz. Yes. We see you.
Yes, what up, Romeo? So, what I wanted to say
Romeo!
About the Dion Cole situation is all this man wore was he just basically took his fashion and went back to the 70s. And majority of the people who are saying it's gay, you might as well call your daddies gay because they all wore bell bottoms.
They all wore bell bottoms.
Polyester suits. Like, you was a sharp ass man if you had on bell bottoms in the 70s. Women wanted you. Wanted to jump your bones.
Nobody wanted the nigga with no bell bottoms.
Exactly. No.
First of all, I'm glad we talked about this because I just thought about this. No man that wear tight ass pants
should say
anything about a man in bell bottoms, because I guarantee you 9 out of 10 of the men who has something to say wear those tight ass pants where they can barely walk.
And we can see your balls.
And you got a yeast infection and you don't even have a vagina.
Hello.
How you do that?
Somebody. Got vaginitis, penisitis.
Right. Tight ass shirts and tight ass pants.
Who
looks homosexual?
Right, and his suit was sharp. Like, seriously?
He was.
Now, let me tell you what's crazy is, all the white people was like, man, that was fine. That was bomb. It was nothing wrong with the suit. It was like, y'all do too much. And it's actually...
Hey, Marlon Tillerson, Big Bomb Tillerson. How are ya?
It's so sad.
Look, it's dope. The comments are coming through.
Well,
3 people loved it.
Can you see the comments?
It's right there.
Oh, nice. Mm-hmm.
Nice. I'm playing with new software. You put producer next to my name. Hello.
She's a woman of many hats.
Somebody.
Yeah.
Who is that? Hey, Key. Miss Traveling Lady.
Auntie Judy's watching.
Auntie Judy, we love
you. Oh, Brenda Thompson just started watching.
Miss Brenda Thompson. We just talked about you, Miss Brenda. We love you so much. I had to shout you out. For Black History Month. And let the people know that you're the first black female and beautiful and fine at that commissioner in the United States. You so freaking dope.
Yes.
And hilarious. And you raised some dope ass women too.
Yes, definitely.
And I'm just glad and honored to know your dope ass.
Hello.
I could talk to Miss Brenda like that because that's how she talks.
She's from Harvey, Illinois, so represent H-Town. Well, Harvey does, because H-Town is Houston. But
right.
Harvey, Illinois.
Yeah, so let's go ahead and get into the topic tonight. The topic is love is blind. I don't know if you all have been blind. Is love blind? But it stems from the Netflix reality show that has been trending everywhere. It's trending on Netflix. Number one is trending number one on Twitter. Today was the final episode was aired today. So I'm going to just we're going to show you a quick clip of what the show is about if you haven't watched it.
Yes, go ahead.
I want to spend the rest of my life with. I've never seen her before.
Here, you will choose someone to marry.
Hello.
Nice to hear from you. Can't say see ya.
Without ever seeing them.
24/7. If you're ready to find the love of your life.
Game time.
The pods are now open.
What kind of work do you do?
So what are some of your biggest turnoffs?
So what are you looking for in a woman?
Ethnicity, race, physical appearance. None of that matters.
I'm really starting to emotionally connect with you.
This could be a remarkable love story.
You're a beautiful person. I don't have to see you to say that.
I'm scared of making the wrong decision.
Can't see my life without you. Will you be my wife?
I am engaged to somebody I've never seen before.
I hope he's just fine, be very attractive.
Can't handle us. Oh my God.
The physical attraction is on par with the emotional connection.
She has become the most important thing in my life.
I want you to be 1,000% open with me.
There's my student debt.
You're a white guy. She's a black woman. Let's talk about that.
This marriage could tear me and my family apart.
This was fate. This is what was meant to be.
You're bringing me down.
You're bringing me down.
Don't insult me like that.
We're getting married, and that's scary.
Do I want to marry him? I don't know.
Do you take her to be your lawful wedded wife?
I cannot do this.
Yes, Nadine, that show.
That show.
Al Stevens. Hello to you.
I actually loved the show from, like, I was hooked from the first episode.
I was too. I was very hooked.
I was hooked from the first episode. I watched the first three in one day when the episode 4 through 6 came on last Thursday. Watched that all at one time. And then today, I was like, ooh.
I don't even cry, but a few people got me teary-eyed.
Okay.
But especially my favorite couple, Lauren and Cameron.
Yes. They've been my favorite since day one.
Yeah, they've been my favorite, too. I just love Cameron. I love that show. And it just comes to the question, is love blind? What do you think? Oh, come on. We're having some technical difficulties, I see. We froze up a little bit. Hopefully we come back.
Right. Fall out.
Right. So we're going to fix this. There we go. All right. So we're back. It's not even that cold outside, but we're back.
Oh, Key, you definitely have to watch it.
Yeah, you have to watch it. Because I'm definitely about to ruin it for those of you who haven't watched. I put up a post. And I warned people. I said, you have an hour to watch the finale.
Yes.
Because I don't want to ruin it for people. But yeah, so I've always believed that love is blind. First of all, the word race irks the fuck out of me. Because I hate when people say I'm dating outside of my race. You're dating another human. It's the human race.
Thank you.
Someone taught you that. I mean, if you want to say nationality, ethnicity, or just somebody that's a different color, because that's all it is.
Because our race is human.
Right.
It's like a species. We ain't different species, we human.
Right. Dogs don't look at each other and go,
that dog is black. Oh, that dog is white and brown. What do they do with dogs?
That dog has spots.
So what do they do with a dog that's tricolor? What do they do?
I don't know. They just lick them, kiss them, and freak on them, and hump on them if they ain't eat. Hump.
Exactly.
I mean, you know, everybody talks about the brain capacity of different mammals and species, but even though ours is the best, if we just use it too much. Mm-hmm. Too much, not only that, somebody taught you to feel a certain way about somebody because of their complexion and skin color. And black people should be the last people doing that because we come in all colors.
Hello, somebody.
All colors. Like, you can have two dark-skinned people and have a kid super duper light.
Yep.
And vice versa. So, it's bananas. What's going on, Paul Piat Jackson? What's going on with you?
That's a nice name, Piat.
I don't know if it's P-I-Pop. I'm sorry, but Paul Jackson, that's you.
Right.
But, yeah, so the show is pretty dope. I love the concept that Nick Lachey and his wife Vanessa Lachey came up with. It's pretty dope. It just takes away, you know, the modern world with social media, phones, everything is about physical. So many shallow people in the world. Like, I'll use my perfect example, perfect couple for example, Cameron and Lauren. Lauren probably never would have dated a white guy.
If she would have fallen, she wouldn't.
But she fell in love with the emotional contact. And it just goes back to what a lot of people say, you know, love is, you know, to have a relationship, the person can't just be fine. You need more than that, but you definitely need that emotional connection because looks fade.
Yeah.
People, bodies change. And I've heard some people say, well, if this person gained too much weight, I'm gone. Well, that means you ain't love their ass from the get-go. You only love what they look like.
It wasn't love, it was lust.
Definitely lust.
It was lust.
That's exactly what it was.
Because if you truly love a person, they lose an arm, a toe, a leg, they gain 50 pounds, you still gonna love them the same because at the end of the day, they're still the same person.
They're still the same person.
Just their
physical is a little, is different. Right. Jessica hated it. I wanted to slap the shit out of her the entire show. She got on my nerves. Well, I'm not going to say the entire show. When she started doing Mark, well, first of all, she did Mark a certain way because of the age. And this was a reason, this was a, so basically it was an experiment because, like Nick Lachey stated, a lot of people, what's the word I'm looking for? Like, kind of like scientists, people who do a lot of different studies, they've learned that most marriages last longer when the emotional connection is very strong and not the physical. Exactly. So this is the reason for, one of the reasons, the main reason for the experiment. You know, so you get age, race, color, height, all of that out of the picture. And here you go with Jessica. She's worried about the fact that Mark's 10 years younger than her. Mm-hmm. So now, I'm not gonna lie. I have been guilty of that. I'm like, I will not date a 24-year-old. Now, for me, it's a little different. I'm not dating anybody that young because I know more than likely they're going to want kids. Mm-hmm. And not only am I not giving you any, I can't give you any. I've been fixed since I was 24. At 24, it was chopped and screwed over here.
So, Carla asked me earlier, would you date somebody 10 years younger? I said, I'm 42. If he's 32, as long as, like, mentally we're on the same level, I wouldn't have a problem. But as long as he doesn't, like, if he's done having kids and he don't want any kids, then yes. But if he wants kids, then no.
Man, I'm not dating a 46-year-old guy who wants kids.
Not at all.
I'm not doing it. Even if I wasn't fixed, I'm...
No. It's me and 50 still want kids, not having...
Bless their heart. Having, well, so you can be here for only 5 or 10 years? No, you crazy as hell. Not at all.
Yeah, Jessica, she get on my nerves.
She get on my last nerve. I wanted to punch that bitch through the TV 1,000 times. Now, like, every tooth out her mouth.
My thing with Mark, I knew she was gonna say no because first of all, Mark was he was an option for her.
Yeah.
That wasn't her first choice. So that lets you know that she just settled with the other person that wanted her.
Yeah. And not only that, when she realized, okay, you know what, we do kind of have a connection, when she saw the physical, she couldn't put the emotional and the physical together. She had an issue with that.
Yep.
And Mark is so dope. He even...
She missed out.
She missed out on
the great one. She missed out on a great
one. Anybody want a great man who want kids, go look up Mark Cuevas on Instagram. If you haven't watched the show, man, that man is
well,
so
he's probably
dope.
26 now, 25. 26,
right.
26.
Oh, that's another thing I learned today, too. They taped that show a year and a half ago.
Wow. I would have never known that.
A year and a half
I
ago.
I would have never known.
So they all have had to keep secrets of the show,
excuse me,
for a year and a half. Not only that, they all, you know, because I've been binge watching videos, interviews, press, all that kind of stuff all day. Mm-hmm. And they even said that for some of them it was hard watching it because they had to relive some of the things that happened, and it was like reopening a wound.
I found out too today when I was looking at some things online that they didn't even show all of the engaged couples. They only showed the 5.
Hmm.
Well, 6, but one of them didn't make it on when they went on their vacation.
Speaking of that,
y'all gotta watch that.
Yeah, man, I'm ruining everything. I hope y'all watched it.
Hey, Kay.
But Kay, who Kay?
Kay Strada.
What up, Fiokas?
Let us see you ski. Show me you ski.
Show me ski, Fiokas. But not only that, you know, I'm glad we were raised in a house where we never. You know, I'm not going to say, I remember, you know, a lot of people say the cliche, I don't see color. That's a lie because we all see color.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only way you match your clothes. That's how you choose the car that you want. Now, as far as being diverse, we grew up in a very diverse family. I have cousins, aunts and uncles who are Mexican, Puerto Rican, white, black, all kind.
Everything. You come to our family reunion, it's a rainbow.
Yeah. So, you know, honestly, there was a guy who I dated briefly for like 2 weeks, a couple of months ago. And the way he talked about white people, I knew, I said, we couldn't be together. Like, I couldn't see myself living my entire life with him, because I wouldn't even be able to bring him to family functions, because I know how you feel about people.
Well, a year and a half ago, there was a guy I had a huge crush on, and we were sitting in his car having a conversation, and he told me he hate white people. I was like, yeah, he ain't the one.
Not gonna work.
Not gonna work.
Hey, Donnie Cross. And my thing is, you know, I don't knock anybody for how they feel and their beliefs, but just know that I don't have to deal with the shit. Exactly. That's all I'm saying.
It's my choice.
You can like what you like, not like what you don't like, just like there are things I like and things I don't like. We are all privileged to have those opinions and things like that. But like I said, just know I don't have to deal with it.
Yes. Now, back to your question, is love blind?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, a lot of people miss out on their soulmates because of
things they've been taught
and
programmed,
looking at the physical.
That too.
Because the highest level of intimacy is communication.
Yes, it is.
That is the highest level of intimacy. People think intimacy is the actual sexual intercourse.
Well, I like that intimacy too.
I mean, yes, that's nice, but I don't know how many of you all have ever been on the phone with somebody you've never seen, and because you all talk on the phone every day for hours, you fall in love fast.
This is true.
And it's not lust, because lust is physical. You haven't even seen them. But just from you all talking about different views, you know, your mental, your spiritual, your emotional, that, man, you'd be like, you know what? I love you. You are my person. And it's to the point where when you finally see them and they may not be used to what your norm is as far as preference, you'd be like, you know what? I can look past that, because I done fell in love with you already.
Now, I'm glad you brought that up, because that's true. Remember the party line? How many of y'all remember the party line?
Oh, my goodness.
So that Thursday, when you could go in different rooms and private chat with people, you actually like people. Like, back in those days, I'm pretty sure it's a lot of people still married
today
that met on the party line.
You gotta know it.
And at that time, dang, that's dope, because that experiment is kind of like how we used to live.
Because you couldn't send people pictures on your phone. Let me see your pictures.
There was no phone to send them. There's no social media to send them. No internet to send them.
A lot of couples today are together because of blind dates. Their friends set them up. You had to sit and talk on the phone because there was no text messages.
Blind dates.
You like, but most of those times you talk to this person every day for a month before y'all finally went on a date and saw each other in person.
And I don't know why people don't pay attention to this. Like, social media, people can use filters. And then you still get upset.
People get catfish.
Right, and then you meet them and you still get upset. But I'm glad you mentioned that, because this is a great point that I saw online today. And I think this interview was from Lauren. I'm sorry. And she said, we were dating about 16 hours a day.
That's a long time.
On the show. So, of course, when we're watching the show, there are a lot of people who are watching and like, I don't know how you could fall in love with somebody just talking to them for a couple of minutes. I'm like, oh, my God, dumbass.
It's TV magic.
Like, these people, they had nothing else to do. No internet, no phones, no outside world. It was just them in those pods talking, and they were able to talk to whoever they wanted to talk to. Right. So, of course, it was kind of like a speed dating thing at first in pods, mm-hmm. until you find, like, there were some people who said, like Mark said he talked to like two women, and then when he got to Jessica, he knew he didn't want to talk to anybody else after that, because the conversation was just different.
Yeah.
Barnett, I binge watched interviews today. Barnett even told ET in an interview that, you know, it was parts they didn't show of why he had a connection with three women. And a lot of people wonder why he chose and proposed to Amber. Mm-hmm. But he said it was, you know, these are the parts that get edited out right. for the goofballs who don't know about, don't we act
call
like.
People goofballs.
Okay, I'm not
people
sorry.
Just don't understand.
No, so that's just.
Don't think.
No, that just have to be real. No, let's be honest. That's goofballish of you to be an adult in the world today of technology.
I'm trying to help
and
y'all
not
out.
Think and to know that shows are edited because they can't put the whole fucking tape on a show. You'll be, we'll still be watching it for months.
Well, look at music videos. They take 5 days to film a 3-minute music video.
A 3-minute video.
So, yeah. And they be filming 14 hours a day for 4 days.
I've been on video sets and it's a very long day.
It takes like a year and a half to film a movie that's only an hour and a half.
An hour, exactly. So for the, and they on set almost all day. People, I'm gonna call them people. Hey, Kenya Steele, are you doing well? Hey, Kenya. Oh, see, that's our, look, Kenya got a new last name. That's our goal. You are goals. We want a new last name. Yeah. But, so like I was saying, Barnett said that he had more of a connection with Amber, but those were scenes that you didn't see.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And
well, they had to do that to get people, you know, editing again.
It's all about drawing people in.
Reeling people in.
Well, all I'm going to say is shout out to the editor because you got me with the first episode.
Man. Hey, Kwani.
We literally, hey, Kwani.
With the first one, I was like,
oh, we literally,
I'm watching this.
Right, they were, I saw online, they were asking how many people binge watch. We binge watch every week of episodes. I'm pretty sure it was a lot of people last week that couldn't wait for the finale episode to drop today.
I couldn't wait. I was like, come on Thursday.
Right. I'm literally watching it, and I'm sitting there like this, like it's me. Like, my stomach is in knots with butterflies.
Wait, Rashida FaceTimed me when I was watching Lauren and Cameron. I'm sitting there like this. I'm talking about my heart was beating fast like it was me getting married, standing on the altar.
Ooh,
OMG, I was so nervous.
Yeah, it was dope. But, okay. I wouldn't mind, like, somebody start like a party line or something. I might start,
man.
I wouldn't mind, like, people setting up blind dates again and get out of, you know, they're not only, like they said, we live in a swipe left world. All these dating apps where you are, you know, if the person doesn't look attractive to you, you just swipe left and you probably swipe the shit out your husband or your wife.
Better know
the person you've been waiting for. Not only that, for the people who say, I don't stay black and stay in the white race, stay Mexican, Chinese, the person for you is probably a different skin color and a different ethnicity than you.
You better know.
Open your mind, open your heart.
Man.
Wash out all that bullshit we've been brainwashed with and taught with all our lives. Here's another point I wanted to make. And like I said, I love everybody. I don't care what you, there's some black folks I can't stand. I mean, it's a lot of people, I don't care what you look like, what color you are. If I can't stand you, I can't stand your ass. But one thing I'm talking about black people right now, one thing I can't stand with y'all is you walk around here still swearing by words of the same people you don't like.
Hmm.
Because it was them who taught you to stay within your race. That is the dumbest bullshit I've ever heard in my life. Because guess what? If your ass on that kidney transplant list,
you gonna want
and
it
you about
anybody.
To die, you won't give a fuck who that kidney
you
came
better,
from.
You better know it.
No, let's take it a step further. Your baby, your child is laying on their deathbed. And they have a whole future ahead of them. Just a whole lot of things they can do in life. And that kidney is coming from somebody of a different ethnicity working perfectly fine. You mean tell me you're going to turn that shit down because you want to stay within your race? Because I'm pretty sure they work in your body the same way.
I highly doubt it because you refuse that kidney. You're going to be on that list for a while because it's going to the next person. The next person going to say, give it to me.
man, definitely.
They ain't gonna say, give it to me, give me that kidney right now.
So Kenya said, I watched the finale and I knew who was actually gonna get hitched.
I did too.
I was hoping.
I did too.
I was hoping that the people I knew was gonna get hitched actually got hitched.
I was only rooting for two couples. And those are the two couples that got me hitched.
Me too. I was rooting for them too.
Yeah. Honestly. Which was Amber and Barnett. And Lauren and Cameron.
Right. So, Kenya said, I remember the party line. LOL, wait. Did I show my age? You definitely showed your age.
You're definitely telling your age if you remember the party line.
Right. But then again, like I said, but back then, there wasn't no filters. You didn't, you know, it was nowhere to post pictures. Your friend said, I got a cousin that I think is good for you.
And y'all talked on the phone.
I want to hook you up with my cousin. Y'all talked on the phone and you fell in love with this person. It didn't take months. It didn't take years. It might take, for some people, it might take a couple of days if y'all sitting on the phone at night for hours. Like, you had no other distractions.
What else did you have to do except go outside and play? And when you came in the house, you was on the phone.
Or Atari, Sega, or Nintendo, on why they were playing and they was on the phone.
They were on the phone, exactly. Playing the game.
Yep. Or if you got to the age, you know, where you were working. Man, they couldn't wait to get home to call you. Or you run home, look at the... Walk. Remember the box, the call ID box, because it wasn't on the phone. You look at the box. Oh, such called me.
But how about before call ID even came out?
Yeah.
You just have to wait to come in the house for everybody in the house to tell you. Anybody call for me? Anybody call for me?
Right.
Anybody call? You was waiting here. You ain't hear that name.
You was waiting. Did such call for me? And no matter what they look, and once you like this person over the phone or fell in love with, here's another thing. I don't believe that falling in love has a time limit.
It definitely doesn't have a time limit. There is no, you can't put time on when you get feelings for a person.
Or what you've been looking for, what you always wanted. So, of course, it's going to happen
faster. I'm going to wait for a year.
For what?
I'm going to wait for a year,
dumbass. You might not live tomorrow. You might not be here tomorrow. What you mean next year? Next year.
Hello.
You know, nowadays, that's a long time from now. That's a long-ass time from now.
365 days is a long
time. Yeah, buddy.
If you go day, you go day by day.
That's hilarious. But, yeah. Love is blind. I'm just looking for my Stevie Wonder. My Ray Charles.
Who else you gonna name?
Fetty Wap. Halfway.
Oh, Jesus.
I can't think of nobody else that's blind.
Helen Keller.
I don't date women.
Oh, well.
I like men. I like poles.
I hate Jill. I'm talking about looking at all these little heartlets.
Heartlets? What are heartlets?
Harlots. Harlots.
Oh, hey, Jilla. We love you and miss you.
Yes, we love you and miss you.
Where's my breakfast and lunch date?
Because you always eating.
Worst little brother ever in the world.
She don't work a job. I don't work a job. We can definitely.
And he knows this, and I'm tired of saying it. Mm-hmm. So listen, Kenya said, if I would have done something like that, I probably would have saved myself from a lot of soul ties that I had to heal from.
Amen to that, Kenya.
Kenya.
Definitely would have not given myself to people who were not deserving.
You made a decision. Dope ass point. I'm glad you're on here and chiming in, because that's a dope ass point. I probably would have done the same thing, but I'm busy, you know, like, oh, you can look like this. I like tall guys. Now, I will say I did switch up. My oldest daughter's father was short. Love that boy to death. Oh, my goodness, loved his dirty draws.
Shoot, my kid's father was the first light skin. I went from straight blue, black to sunrise yellow.
I think that's the first chunky guy you dated, too.
He was the first light-skinned and first chunky guy. Because if anybody knows me, like, I always like them chocolate and look like linebackers. Like, I mean, muscular. Because that's how my daddy looked.
Yeah, I get that. I feel
that. Now, Kwani said, that's true. Ronnie and I have a 13-year age difference. But at the time we met, we both were looking for the same thing, which was to be with someone who only wanted to be with us.
Mm.
That's why I love you.
And look at him.
Oh my goodness.
And I love watching them. They're such a dope couple.
So dope.
I could tell they're so best dope. Friends.
Yes.
Ronnie just let Kwani be herself.
Yep. They can be themselves. Exactly. That's the best. When you can be yourself and nobody is like, you know, you should change this and change that. Now it's negative stuff, okay, but you just being yourself and it's not a problem. Like, and that's another thing. That's a lot of people's problem too. With the whole Love is Blind situation is because when people see the physical, they always want to change something physically about that person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, I dated a guy that told me, you'll be perfect if your stomach was flat.
Woo! What? Oh, no. The audacity.
Everything about
me. He said that?
Everything about me was perfect, but I didn't have a flat
stomach. But is this the same person who cries now because he lost you?
Yes.
Wow. Amazing.
Because my physical appearance wasn't...
But I think you're pretty pretty.
I mean, he said I was pretty and beautiful, but...
You just had that stomach.
I have a stomach.
Something that you can work on.
Something that I can definitely be changed. But that, hey, that's people's problem.
It definitely is. What's going on, Alexis Cruz? Where? Bye.
So, Kwani said, really, love really doesn't have color, but a requirement. Make sure you make your requirements clear. That way, the other person can yay or not. And that's true. When I was watching the interview of, who was it? It was Giannina. I thought it was Giannina. It's an A at the end.
Yeah, that's weird. Gianina, it took a lot of us a long time to
pronounce it. Gigi, that's what they call it. Gigi.
Right, Gigi.
Gigi and Gigi. Damien. And she said that, too. She said that was the good thing about being in the pods and not seeing a person is because when you're not face to... No, I'm sorry. It was Barnett who said it when I was watching him and Amber's interview. He said, the great thing about being in the pods when you're talking to a person and you're not seeing them face to face, you're more open to about what it is that you want and you don't want because you're not in fear of, let me not say this because I don't want to lose them because I'm looking at these looks.
Right.
So that is definitely a great point, Kwani. So, like, again, on the phone, it's easier to talk to a person on the phone, but we all do that. It's easier to talk when you're not face-to-face with a person than when you see them face-to-face.
That's true.
And, you know, because if they, you can't see facial expression or anything, you're being 100% yourself.
Now, this is why everybody loves Cameron. I watched something, and Cameron said that one of the things he loved about being in the pods is because Lauren is so beautiful that it distracts him every time he looks at her.
Wow. Wow, that's deep.
But you want to know what makes a person... You want to know... Okay, so here's the thing. She's already beautiful, but the reason she's so beautiful to him... is because he got to know the inner before he saw the outer.
Exactly.
And that definitely makes a difference.
Makes a huge difference. Huge difference.
Yes, indeed.
Huge. Like, I'm old school, because if I'm dating a guy, you have to talk on the phone. All that texting is so impersonal. Just, let's talk. If we can't talk on the phone for hours, and you be real, and I be real...
Yeah, I love somebody. I'm old school, too. I love talking on the phone. Hey, trust me, guys who have tried to get close to me, and I say tried because they failed. But I tell people all the time, I will text me all the time. It's going to turn me off. You cannot get to know me through no goddamn text.
I told somebody
things get so
before.
Misunderstood.
And he still didn't pick up the phone, so I was like...
Well, too bad. Really? So sorry for you, sucker. Your loss.
I get a text every blue moon. Hey, love.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to find someone. I'm going to set up some pods. And I'm going to get some people married. And, oh, not only that, I forgot to mention this. These people got married within 6 weeks of meeting the person.
Yeah.
And you only got to meet them face-to-face if the guy proposed and asked them to marry them. So they proposed to somebody who they had never seen before. That's how you know when it's genuine.
Definitely. Now, Kara said, yes, I love this show. I know that I could do this concept. I definitely would love, like, if they
I would love
called
it.
Me for season 2, put me on there.
And a lot of people, they asked Lauren, and a lot of people, did they regret doing it? She said she had no regrets.
Nope.
And she said she'd do it again.
She said she'd been looking for Cameron for 30
for
years.
For 30 years. But guess what? Again, ding, ding, ding. She didn't run into him because she wouldn't date a white man.
She wouldn't date a white man because she was so pro-black and for black people being with black people. And then she met this guy and didn't even see him. She didn't even know he was white until they saw each other face to face.
She said she didn't know what he was.
She didn't know what he was because if you listen to his voice, you really can't tell.
But what she did know was that his inner, his soul is what she had been looking for.
Yep.
And just she just got so blessed that he's easy on the ass.
Yes.
And clearly easy in the pants too, because she had nothing to say.
She said it wasn't what she expected.
It wasn't what she expected. I keep trying to tell women because I dated a Chinese guy for a year and a half and they've been lying to us forever. I keep telling people go to Chinatown to find you one. We ain't even thinking about the coronavirus right now because some of these Negroes got things worse than a goddamn coronavirus.
Like HIV?
But go, yeah. But go find you an Asian. Go find you some. Anybody, as long as they have what you want on the inside. Because I know a lot of y'all that don't want to date outside your race and ain't shit happened with none of the niggas you've been dating all your life.
Hmm. You might find your man at the beauty supply. He might be Korean.
Well, actually, I don't know if I like that fine Korean dude that worked at the beauty supply over on Garfield.
Now, Clifford yes, Ayer Lord. Said, y'all finished it already. I just saw the first episode. You got to catch up, Cliff.
You got to catch up real good.
Kiana said, I'm late. I'll have to catch up. You better binge watch it, girl. You ain't going to go to sleep.
Hey, beautiful.
And then Kyra said, yes, he was super affectionate with her the whole time.
Yes.
The new episode is on Netflix now. I watched it earlier, honey. It was on today. So watch it tonight.
Not only that, when like they cried with each other and didn't even see each other.
Exactly.
Yet. It got that deep and emotional.
They got super deep. And what I loved about Lauren, her biggest fear was what her dad was going to think. But again, because he loves his daughter so much, he said, if you love him, I like him.
Mm-hmm.
And he knows, and I mean just being her dad, because she's been so long, single so long, when he talked to Cameron, he knew, like,
this is the man for my daughter.
He's white, but this is a great guy. He loves my daughter to death.
Mm-hmm.
Men know when men are really, really in love with a woman. They know.
Oh, yeah. Somebody said, OMG, I'm about to.
Jilla said, she's right. She's still out here trying to trick these niggas, huh?
That's an insider
y'all won't understand.
That inside joke has been going on for like almost 20 years.
I don't think it'll ever stop.
But just know it's because I'm cool with the dudes. No.
Yeah. So you definitely... Like, conversing on the phone with somebody for hours, even though y'all be like, we friends, y'all start to like and love each other.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind. I'd do a blind date.
Oh, Kwani, it's on Netflix. It's called Love is Blind.
Binge watch the
you
shit out
of you and Ronnie binge watch it
right.
together.
Get your snacks
day.
Together.
Yes, because y'all not going to be able to sleep. You don't have to force yourself to turn it off. But Love is Blind on Netflix.
And y'all gonna fuck around and start having conversations behind walls and shit. Building your connection back before you get your vows renewed.
That was another thing on the show that was huge for me. When some of the couples, when they had disagreements, they went back to how they started.
Yeah, Mark did that.
And that's the one thing that people always talk about. You have to go back to what brought you all together. So what they would do is go in separate rooms and talk. Again, that goes back to what I said. It's easier to talk to a person when you're not face to face. And I love that they showed that on the show because a lot of them resolved their issues going back to talking in separate rooms. That was super dope.
Now, for me, the only time I would say the physical would get in the way of how I feel about somebody is if we are sexually incompatible.
Like, if he 400 pounds and you can't even reach the penis?
Well, like or if it's just...
But we can go to the gym and work that out.
You can. But
you can change that again.
Yeah, but I'm talking about the ones that you can get to, but it don't work right. You know what? Work right as far as what? Because when you're in love with a person, because I've been here before, when your emotion is there with a person, size don't matter because you so emotionally attached.
I didn't say size. I said don't work right.
Oh, meaning it won't stay up.
Yeah.
Or get up.
Or any of that. Well, or last long.
Well, I know doctors that'll fix that again.
Or last long.
Sure, you can try some energy drinks.
I'm a very sexual person, and I don't care what nobody say. Sex is very high percentile in any relationship. Because if you look at the two top reasons why people don't last or divorce, is finances and not getting any sex.
Huh. Well, whoever my husband is out there, whoever you are, just know I will never say no. I will never say I'm tired.
Headaches? Who have those?
That's what ibuprofen is for.
Sleep? Who need that?
That's what naps are for.
Tired? What?
Period.
Tired.
It's more than one way to skin a cat.
Ha ha, did you say period? Oh, man.
Kiana said, go get those gas station pills. Yes, sir.
Yes.
If he can't last, we're gonna find you some stamina. If we got to drive around and pop some, we're going to find you. Right, car, sex, and finances.
Those are the top two. Let me tell you something. You can have some good sex and things work right, and a woman will help you come up with some finances. Do you hear me? But if nothing's happening.
Sorry, Cabin.
Or you can be rich. But if your body parts are in debt, so nothing happening whatsoever. You got a lot of comments over there. Your page cracking.
Yeah, Kara said, or lack of both, or too much. High sex drive will run a dude away because he can't compete. You know, men need to put them egos to the side.
Why?
She said sometimes women will have sex drives run men away because he can't compete. So to him,
is that why I'm still single? Mm-hmm. Somebody tell me I need to get myself together. It's ghosting here. Oh,
what's that?
I don't know what that was.
Oh, that was a bad.
Oh,
just fine. It wasn't a, ain't nothing break.
Oh, okay. Well, we're gonna go ahead and get out of here. I'm telling y'all right now, I was going to say a lot of things, but I don't want to ruin the show for people who haven't watched it. Yo, watch that shit tonight. I'm telling you, you're going to binge watch it.
Yes.
Hurry up and watch it because I'm talking about it next week. We're going to do a part two. So I'm trying to help y'all catch up.
Jilla said he's a rich woman's lover and a poor woman's dream.
You know what? We're going to block Jilla. So he can no longer comment on these lives.
No, I love him. He needs to comment on every time we go live.
He needs to come be a guest. No,
he definitely needs to come be a guest.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, bro. You need to come be a guest on the show.
Oh, hey, Tifa. Tifa said, hey, Mom. Hey. Oh, she's watching. Yay. I love when the babies support. I love when they support.
Kiana said she's about to watch it. Now, we love you too, Kara. Armando, it is on Netflix. It's called Love is Blind on Netflix. Watch it.
Now I'm gonna tell you right now, do not go on social. If you're gonna watch it,
don't
stay
go on social media,
off social media. It's like power. People will ruin it for you. People will ruin it for you. I found Cameron on Instagram, and in his post, he told people, some people haven't watched it yet, and he put, please do not ruin it for those who didn't. And what people do in the comments? They don't listen. They don't listen. But yeah. Y'all go ahead and watch that. We're going to get out of here because I think I'm going to watch the finale again tonight because it was just so dang on good. Oh my goodness.
It was good. Yes. It was good.
Yeah.
But I was happy.
Yeah, I was.
I was happy.
So I just want to thank everybody. Well, we want to thank everybody for tuning in.
Yes,
thank you
all
for
so
those
much.
Who continuously support us. We love you.
Yes.
If you haven't yet, please go subscribe to our YouTube channel.
your favorite Lucas twins. And not only that, you can follow Dalila on Instagram at Dalila Twin. And you can follow me on Instagram at Rashida Lucas 5. You already know our Facebook page just because you're watching it on Facebook. Hello. Oh, no. For the YouTube watchers. On Facebook, I am Rashida J. Lucas. That's R-A-S-H-I-D-A. And she is Dalila Lucas on Facebook.
Yes. Couldn't forget about that.
Until my last names change.
Until they
change. We'll still be your favorite Lucas twins, though.
Oh, we'll always be your favorite Lucas twins.
Always.
Yes, we will.
But guess what?
What?
We out of here.
Oh, deuces, y'all. So go watch Love is Blind. Get your snacks. Get your covers. Get your boo. Get your wine. Make sure you pee and boo-boo before you do so there's no interruptions.
And share this. When you subscribe to our YouTube channel, share that as well. Let people know we're getting our viewers up, get our subscribers up. We got some things we got planned we want to do, but we got to get our following up. And we need your support, beautiful, loving people.
We love you too, Ray Ray. We miss you too, Jilla.
Yes, love and miss all of you guys. So thanks for tuning in. I am Rashida Lucas.
And I am Dalila Lucas.
And we are your favorite Lucas twins.
Good night, y'all. Love you.